Hello everyone, welcome to Easy QuickBooks Training, where you can get how-tos, tips and tricks, and troubleshooting for QuickBooks. Today I'm going to show you how to password protect your data. I'm not talking about putting a password in QuickBooks when you log in. I'm talking about protecting your data that you've already reconciled and you don't want no one to make changes to it. So let's get started. I will show you how to do this in QuickBooks Online and on the desktop version. Let's do QuickBooks Online first. In order to password protect your data, you need to go to the gear icon, go to Account and Settings, and then under the Advanced tab, you'll be able to see where it says Close the Books. And you want to click on that and you want to check the box Close the Books. Now it's going to give you two boxes. Then you want to put the closing date. I do it every quarter or every other 2 months so my clients don't change anything in the close periods. So let's say I want to close for December 31st of 2016. Then under that, we have two options. We can allow changes after viewing and warning that they will be changing something in the closed period, or we can allow changes after entering a password. I usually do this one after entering a password. And then I create a password. And that password's only for myself, unless I want to give it to the owner and he could do changes, but it's only for myself. And I click Save. That way, if someone wants you to make a change, they will let you know and you can do it for them. So I save that, and now we have the password to make changes. That's how you do it on QuickBooks Online. Now let's go to the desktop version. And I will show you how to do it there. There's two ways to get to the password protection on QuickBooks Desktop. The first one is going to be under Company, and then go under Set Closing Date. Or you can go, let me show you what it looks like. Set Closing Date. It takes you to the Preferences. Or you can go to Edit, Preferences, then Company Preferences. So under here, it says Set Date Password. It's almost the same as QuickBooks Online. And you can exclude estimate sales orders and purchase orders, but we don't want to exclude that because if they change any of those, then they're changing your sales, your revenue. So we don't want to exclude those. Okay, so let's see. We can do ending date, and also we can enter a password. So when they want to change something, it's going to request a password. And then you just save. Okay, that's how you password protect your data in QuickBooks Online and QuickBooks Desktop. If you like this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my YouTube channel to get more tips and tricks for QuickBooks. I will see you on the next one.